Good to have you with us. I'm Avani Raja. Let's straight get to the top angle that we're tracking now at this point in time. You know, the government has decided to form four more interministerial teams that will visit Ahmedabad, Surat, Chennai, as well as Hyderabad. Now, the government said that while six teams have already begun work in the states they were sent to, four more teams have now been formed to check on some of these areas and cities where the number of coronavirus cases have been rising. Take a look.
गृह मंत्रालय ने आपदा प्रबंधन अधिनियम के अंतर्गत छह इंटर मिनिस्ट्रियल सेंट्रल टीम्स का गठन किया था, जो अपने अपने निर्धारित स्थानों पर पहुंचकर उन्होंने काम शुरू कर दिया है। इसके अलावा कोविड-19 के संक्रमण की स्थिति को देखते हुए आज गृह मंत्रालय ने चार और इंटर मिनिस्ट्रियल सेंट्रल टीम्स का गठन किया है, जो अहमदाबाद, सूरत, हैदराबाद और चेन्नई भेजी जा रही हैं। ये टीमें भी भारत सरकार के एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी लेवल अधिकारियों द्वारा लीड की जा रही हैं। इनमें पब्लिक हेल्थ के स्पेशलिस्ट और डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट के स्पेशलिस्ट हैं।
Meanwhile, the government also said that the doubling rate of coronavirus cases in the country has steadily been improving. In fact, it has slowed down further and now stands at 10 days. Listen.
पहले दो हफ्ते जैसा कि आप देखेंगे कि क्यूमुलेटिव केसेस हमारे कितने रहे, 1251 थे पहले, वो 4421 हुए दूसरे हफ्ते के अंत में। इसमें हमारा डबलिंग टाइम जो आप देखते होंगे रोजाना, और जिससे कि आप सभी काफ़ी हद तक वो भी होते जानकारी भी आपको मिल चुकी होगी कि हमारा डबलिंग टाइम इसमें डिक्रीज हुआ था। कारण क्योंकि जो इन्फेक्टेड लोग हमारी कम्युनिटी में आ गए थे उन सब लोगों को अगले 14 दिन में किसी न किसी रूप में लक्षण के माध्यम से सामने आना ही था, और उनके आने के दौरान हमारा डबलिंग टाइम या हमारा केस एक सीमा से बढ़ना था। लेकिन उसी के फलस्वरूप आप अगले दो हफ्ते में देखेंगे कि 7 से लेकर 20 अप्रैल तक हमारे इसमें हमने देखा डबलिंग टाइम में किस तरीके का इजाफा हुआ, या हमने अपने केसों को दोगुना करने की रफ्तार में किस प्रकार एक रोकने और एक ब्रेक लगाने की उस पद्धति में सफलता पाई। तो यह मैं आपको बताना चाहूंगा कि आज की तारीख में जो हमारा डबलिंग रेट 9 दिन तक पहुंच गया है, यह एक दिखाता है कि जो पेंडेमिक एक गति से तेजी से फैलाव कर रहा था दुनिया में, जिसने बहुत सारे देशों को अपने उसमें ले लिया है, वो उस पेंडेमिक पे हम किस हद तक अपने इन प्रयासों के दौरान कुछ हद तक रोक लगा पाए।
And some important news that's coming in. Niti Aayog member VK Paul has said that all states have been told that they can go ahead with the convalescent plasma therapy, provided that ICMR, that's the Indian Council of Medical Research's protocol for plasma therapy, are strictly followed. Those are the details that are coming in at this point in time. This is important news that's coming in. Remember, some states have already started plasma therapy experimentation. In fact, Delhi as well being one of the places which has started. Let me go across to Ayushman joining us for more on this first. Ayushman, first off, help us understand this now. Obviously, there are some states which have started plasma therapy, and now, of course, all states will be able to go ahead and experiment with plasma therapy at this point.
Avni, this was a request which was coming from several states, and today in the briefing, after the briefing, VK Paul, who was there, he said that all these states have been told that if they follow the ICMR protocol, which is the lead guidelines for the convalescent plasma therapy, they can continue it. But it is still it is there in the clinical trial only. Like Delhi CM today said that the donors are donors have to be there. The terminally ill patient, we know that only 5% of cases in this COVID-19 require ventilation, and it has to be used on terminally ill patients. In Delhi, we have seen 4 patients were administered plasma from the donors, and they have shown some progress. And today, the Delhi Chief Minister did a PC. So on that only, this was a question which was posed to the Niti Aayog member who was there present in the PC, and he said that all these states have been told that they can carry out this, but the protocols of ICMR must be followed in that.
Yes, absolutely, Ayushman. So that is one important piece of development that is coming in right now. Aishwarya, if you can also take us through some of the important points that were mentioned in the center's briefing today, because while, of course, the numbers have been steadily rising, the silver lining is that the doubling rate has slowed down and the recovery rate is on its way up.
In fact, the recovery rate has now gone past 20% in India. That means on every 100 patients who are currently in there in the hospitals, 20 people are getting cured. First of all, the interministerial team, which was formed, now those teams, because there were questions being raised as to why the teams are not being sent in Gujarat. So two places in Gujarat, Ahmedabad and Surat, these teams will be going. They'll also be going to Hyderabad and Chennai. These are the serious hotspots that the Home Ministry has said. And at the same time, the Health Ministry has said that because of the lockdown, the current doubling rate of India has gone past 10 days. And in the coming days or weeks, we will find that if the current situation prevails, we'll see a larger number of days getting added to the doubling rate. Also, importantly, the IMCT team, which went to Mumbai, they visited Dharavi and Wadala, in which they said that people aren't normally coming and congregating during the uses of a public toilet. And it is very important for the government to install portable toilets so that the congregation is not there. At the same time, in Indore, they said that 20 hotspots were there where the situation is very serious, Avni.
Absolutely, Ayushman. So some important details coming in and four more.